There she is, finally.
Sorry for being late, sir.
Do you have the documents?
Yes, sir.
sign that for me, please?
I'm sorry, but what is this?
Confidentiality agreement. You know, this corporation prides itself in employing the best workforce on the planet. And this is because of our highly refined interview process that we have developed over the last few years that this is possible. And I just sit there calmly. That's good. She'll go about business. Don't mind her.
Sir?
Yes.
Is this necessary?
That, yes. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'll ask you some warm-up questions so that you can ease into it.
Oh, okay, sir.
What is your age?
28.
Good. Favorite number? Yes.
4382.
Really? Favorite color?
Green.
Again?
Maroon.
Calm down. Again?
Pink.
Thank you. Now everything seems to be in order. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Now I understand that how this works. We'll begin with the actual interview.
Yes, sir.
Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
First question. Why do you want to work for this corporation?
Oh, well, I wanted to work here for a long time now. Ever since I was in college, I've admired the work this corporation has done over the years, and I've always wanted to be a part of it. Every single person in this country is affected in some way or the other by what you do. Not even our government can say that. It's a boldness I would like to be a part of.
Boldness? You think that's what we are? Bold? And are you bold like us?
Yes, I am.
Don't you think you're not giving us enough credit though? I mean, look at it. Boldness, right? That's a sort of a word that someone would use to describe a teenager who has just asked his girlfriend for sexual intercourse.
No, sir.
No, you said so yourself that would touch the lives of each and every citizen of this country, right? So don't you think that's a little more than just being bold?
Well, maybe that's not the best.
See, maybe. But that's just a word. And what's in a word?
No, sir. What I meant to say was, this company has a vision.
What kind of vision? Myopic?
This is a progressive company.
Progressive towards what? Bisexuality?
This is a strong corporation.
It's strong?
Powerful. Ruthless.
And are you ruthless like us? You said that's a quality you admire about us, right? So are you ruthless like us?
Yes, I am.
But now it sounds a bit negative, doesn't it? You know, ruthless, vicious, cutthroat. That's a phrase you so often that sometimes you forget. In order to be a cutthroat, cutthroats have to be done. Figuratively or otherwise, but that's what I think. What do you think?
Well, sir, I think if you call me cutthroat, I take it as a compliment.
What animal would you best describe you?
Animal?
Yes.
Tiger.
Really?
Yes.
That's a very dramatic choice.
Well, that's what I am. Tiger.
Tiger lives in the wild, nearly extinct. Every part of its natural resources is being horribly exploited.
No, sir.
You think that best describes you?
No, sir. That's not what I meant.
See, I understand what you meant, okay? But you must understand that there is a difference between the perception of what we are and the reality of what we are. Okay? So you should just discard this tiger persona of yours. It's a bit outdated. And truthfully, our grandchildren will be lucky if they ever get to see one.
Sir, I'm sorry.
No, it's all right.
No, it's just that I've never really thought of myself as an animal a little bit.
Really? Yes. Okay, backtracking.
No.
No attempt to defend.
Panda! Panda!
It's all right. Now, what is your primary reason for wanting this job?
Well, I think it would be a wonderful opportunity to...
Lying?
Well, I think it would be excellent for my career.
Liar.
I think it would be a strong contribution.
Pants on fire.
I need the money.
You need the money? But then don't we all? You had quite a few years of experience.
Yes, sir.
What about your colleagues? What were they feeling towards you?
good. I was never really close to anyone.
Really? No close friends at all?
No, not really.
What about your female colleagues? What were they feeling towards you? That's interesting. Your readings are going off the chart now. So there must be a story in there somewhere. Okay, tell me. Did you have a girlfriend in your previous place?
No, sir. No, I didn't.
You're not being truthful now. You're trying to tell me that you didn't do anything proper. Is that what you're trying to say?
Well, I may have on occasion.
Did you sexually harass any of your colleagues?
I didn't harass. I didn't harass per se, sir.
Then what did you do?
Well, there was this intern. I might have been a bit lewd with her.
How?
Sir, I don't think I need to ask these questions.
Excuse me! I'm the one who is conducting this interview. I'll ask whatever at least. I'll need to know the full extent of this. So carry on with this intern of yours. Please, carry on.
Well, this one time, I asked her to collect a file for me from this building across the road. Now when she didn't bring it properly, I went to check up on her. And there she was, alone in the records room, bent over, rummaging through some files. And she was wearing a skirt.
What color? Skirt.
Cream. And it had been a while since the last, anyway, so I pretended to help her, and then moved my hand up her skirt, briefly, and then I had to find the file.
Then what did she do?
She froze for a moment. She didn't look at me. Just handed me the file. I was scared. I could see she was upset. I was afraid she'd complain and lose my job. But thankfully she never did.
Were you pleased with yourself?
I felt terrible, sir.
Did you do it again?
Yes.
How many times?
7-8 times.
What? Were you under the impression that she was enjoying this?
Maybe.
What do you mean? Maybe.
This one time, she was looking sullen, depressed, and she had been acting strangely the whole day. It was bothering me. She was wearing a skirt that day.
What? Black.
So I thought I'd try it again. But this time, when I touched her, she didn't freeze. No. In fact, I can't be sure, but I think it was she that brushed up against my hand. Of course, I thought I was imagining things. So I went to help her find the file. But there it was on the floor in front of her. She had found it before I'd gotten there. She was waiting for me. Well, I was too scared after that, sir. I didn't try it again.
Now, why did you tell me all this?
No, why? What? You asked me?
Wait. Now, if you work for me, would you try and grope my secretary?
What?
Would you?
No.
Why not? Doesn't she look at her skirt as a last one?
But sir, that's not the point.
You must have noticed her when she was in her earlier. She's quite pretty. She takes excellent care of her body. It's very difficult not to notice that. Hurry! In fact, you must be devising your strategy ever since you laid eyes on her.
Sir, if I work for you, I'll never be an improper with your secretary, sir.
Why not? Why not? I have. I may not call it behaving improperly, because eventually it led to a consensual relationship. And we have been together for the past 7 months now.
I see.
I know what you're thinking. You're thinking that this man is probably old enough to have a wife and children of his own?
No, sir.
No, you're right. A very irritating wife and two even more bloody irritating children. And I'm screwing my secretary on the side. I really hate being such a cliche. But I've come to understand that it has become cliche for a reason. Secretaries are just so...
Convenient.
Yes,
convenient.
I've hired her personally, not for her typing skills, of course. She is available for me for long working hours. She stays back whenever I want her to. So you see, it's an excellent arrangement. Usually I would frown upon the concept of even keeping a mistress, but that pretty little creature sitting out there, she worships me. And with worship comes considerable amount of obedience and loyalty. What do you think about that?
Well, it sounds like a perfectly good understanding, sir.
Understanding implies an equal contribution. See, that's what I said, there are no two ways about it.
Of course.
If I am to handle the responsibilities entrusted to me by this corporation, then the complete authority over that girl requires no more than a whisper here and a word there. Do you understand?
It sounds like a perfectly good arrangement, is what I meant to say.
Are you fucking patronizing me?
No.
Is that what I tried to do?
Of course not.
You know what sickens me about your little upskirt story? It's not the fact that your social life is so bloody pathetic. But rather, you saw what you wanted for the longest time, that impending in front of you, and still you didn't do anything about it, even after practically she threw herself at you. And you dare to call yourself the embodiment of nature's finest predators. Rubbish, tiger my ass.
But sir, I thought we decided...
Shut up! Lost my fucking day, of course. What was wrong? Still, I'm obligated to give you a full and thorough interview. I'm going to call in one of my colleagues now. He'll carry on with the interview until I feel the need. Do you have a problem with that?
No, sir.
Hello, Keith. Get now and head to my office, please. Quickly. Thank you.
Sir, I apologize.
No, it's fine. It's all right. It's all part of the job, you know. If one isn't really willing to dig through the dirt to uncover all these uncomfortable issues at an interview, then one isn't really doing his job. Refill? You can't have stopped the interview.
Okay.
So what do you think?
It has a smoky, maltish flavor, sir.
I meant my method of interview.
But I'd say it's more unconventional.
You were expecting a more straightforward interview?
Of course.
I bet you had it all figured out. Even before you walked in here, you had a list of question answers. And you know all the perfect answers to them, which is fine usually. But then how does it help me? It tells me nothing about you. It tells me nothing about how valuable you can be to this corporation.
But sir, how does anything
you
discuss so far
tell you that? See, that's exactly my point. You come in here with a ready-made sentence of question and answers and you tell me exactly what I... Hello, Keith. Come here. This is the young man I've been putting under scrutiny.
Really? And how is he holding up your assault?
Rather well. I think he has shown some really impressive resilience with the pressure.
Really? You must be quite a guy. It's not like him to say something like that.
No, he had a couple of shaky moments. But I still think he's doing rather well.
I'm sure.
I thought you would like to have a go at him for a bit.
Oh, well, after that intro, I can't wait.
Okay, then, that's great. I'll be downstairs. You'll have my office to yourself.
Sir. I must say I'm feeling a bit uncomfortable.
Come on, you'll be fine.
Yes, of course, I'll be fine. I mean, from what you've told me, he wouldn't be alive. You'll have to come back here and pick up the pieces.
I promise to be gentle.
See?
I'm so scared now. I don't know what to do.
Did I tell you? He's a sharp one, this fellow.
I'm looking forward to the challenge.
Okay, then I won't delay it any further. Carry on, boys.
You'll have to give me a minute. I'm caught a little off guard.
Of course. Let's just turn this back. Yes, sir.
Alright. So, which department are you thinking to work in?
Management.
I see. And do you feel you are qualified enough for that?
Yes, sir. My work experience is right over here.
That's nothing to me. Just words on paper with no meaning to them. What have you written? Achieve.
Nothing!
Because you see, in this building, every day means the possibility of changing this country. That's quite a responsibility. Do you think you can handle it?
Well, sir, I don't think that kind of responsibility will be entrusted to me.
Why not?
Well, maybe not immediately, but I guess eventually.
But you should do it. Eventually.
I suppose.
Here's a simple math problem. There is a lotus placed in the center of this lake. It doubles to cover the lake in 14 days. Now, if I place another lotus in the same lake, how long will it take to cover it?
13 days.
What?
13 days. It'll take 13 days.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir. If one lotus takes 14 days to cover the lake, then two lotuses should cover half the lake each in 13 days. So it has
to. Who the fuck do you think you are? You think you can come in here and charm him? Then him your little jokes, astonish him with the natural math skills, and you shove him the ladder. There is a line. A long line. And it's taken me years.
I think there's been some kind of misunderstanding, sir.
Oh, you're going to take us in now. Insulting my intelligence, you little shit! Why did he call me here?
What?
Why did he stop the interview and call me here right now?
I don't know.
He wanted to show you off to me. He wanted to show me that in a matter of minutes, your charm has thrown out of his favor.
Sir, I really don't think of his intention, sir.
Shut up! This is my interview. And you will only speak to me when I have asked you a question. What did he promise you?
Nothing.
You're lying. I don't even need to look at the machine. I know you're lying. What did he promise you?
That
what?
What? That he would take care of me.
Should have known. All these years, he told me my time was coming. Soon. So I kept waiting. I stayed loyal. Wasn't the truth? He never thought I was good enough. And he lied to me. All these years, he found this special land. All those bloody interviews. For
days?
Yes! But you don't know about that, huh? Only a few minutes and you've jumped in! Oh? Is the police from vodka? And you promised not to tell me about sports and women?
Not sports.
I bet he thinks I'm going to give you a bad score of spite. Anything good, right? And hire you anyway, just to make me look bad. You think I'm going to let a fucking bastard knock me? You're wrong. Let him hire you. Once you're in my territory,
my checkpoint
will be seeing only last night. Well on him! Two bonus points. Smiley.
Hello?
Yes, we didn't get it done here.
Who's this?
Yes, that's an important thing to take care of.
Who is this?
Yes, thank you very much.
Asshole.
I'll see you soon. What did you say?
Wait.
Hello, sir.
Are you for an interview?
Yes, sir.
Let me see your resume.
Of course.
National sports champion.
Yes, sir. Sumo wrestling. Oh no, sir.
It's just that I've also a new job lately.
Hello.
And a new diet.
Hello. I've also got a very bad diet.
Hello.
Of bad resumes. Okay. So what I'm gonna do with yours?
No, sir.
Come on, take a guess.
No, sir. Really,
come,
I
on, come on, come on.
Sir,
Keith, are you mad?
Clean that up. Don't you ever come back here. What did you say? I'm a man. Oh, wait a minute. I'm really mad. Hello? Hello? Kriti? Hello? Hello? Rami? Hello? Hello? Kriti? 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 Stupid bitch! Fuck up!
You do realize that And if you say a word about this to anybody, our lawyers will make you regret this.
Of course, I won't say a word.
Hello, sir.
You are here for the interview?
Yes, sir.
Can I see your resume, please?
Resume? What for, sir?
What for? I'm going to put ketchup on it and eat it, that's why!
Please go easy on him, he's had a doctor already.
Oh, you had a doctor already? It's going to get what? But what?
Relax, you'll be fine.
Just wait.
Yeah.
You have been sitting here all this while?
Yes, sir.
And still you have managed to pour yourself some water, I can see.
Well, your secretary managed to pour me a glass.
How did it go?
Oh, well, she's a very sweet girl.
With Keith?
I'd say pretty well.
Pretty well. Then let's just look at the score Keith has given you. 12 out of 10. 2 bonus points. Smiley face. That's interesting because usually Keith is very disapproving of new applicants.
He seemed excited by my answers. Sir, he is trying to undermine me and he asked you to help him. No, how did you get this score? He asked me a question about some notice and he got that right. Yeah, so that's a very simple question. It's not that everyday. No, it's staying that way. That kind of score you're planning something with him. No, sir, I'm not.
Of course you are. It's all over your face. That little fucker thinks that he'll pull off shit like this and nobody will care. Well, not until I say so. I'm not going to flood upper management with unworthy fuckers like him and you. You think you can use his help and get behind my back? And when you'll get behind my back, you'll stab me?
Sir, I haven't made any deal with you, sir.
Don't trust you. There's a conspiracy going on here.
Oh, you can switch on the machine if you like.
You want me to switch on the machine? Is it?
If it'll make you believe me.
You think that if I switch on the machine, I'll believe you?
It is the right thing,
isn't it?
Is it? I don't know. That's what you said. You've been using the office wire.
No, sir, I'm really sorry because I haven't been giving you enough credit. You sneaky little bastard!
What?
I know what's happening now. You and Keith have teamed up and now you both are trying to fuck with me!
No, sir, I don't know what you're talking about!
Bastards. You both have teamed up? Oh, he has told you that this machine isn't even real.
What?
Quit this fucking schoolboy act, okay?
Sorry, sir.
You both think that now you know everything about me. What I mean when I'm saying something, what I want to hear from applicants, how I change my methods around there. Okay, can I say something? Keith knows nothing about my methods, nothing! Sorry, where was I?
Methods, yes.
He knows nothing about my methods. I change my methods every day around here in this building. That's what you need to do in a corporation like this. You need to evolve, constantly evolve. And that's what I do. I evolve around here.
Sir, but I haven't made the deal with you, sir.
I don't trust you. And if I don't trust you, I'm not gonna hire you.
No, sir, but I'm not lying to you. What can I do to do with you, sir?
Prove what? Prove that I can trust you.
Yes, sir, I'll do anything.
Anything? Look at the wall! since you are volunteered to help me, there might be something you could do for me. I've told you earlier that I was having an affair with my secretary. So what's happening in the department is, I've grown bored of her arrangement. And it's not the girl's fault really, she's still very pretty and whatever. But you must understand that if one is having an affair for a certain amount of time, then things get a little monotonous. You understand? Okay, you can look at me now.
I'm very sorry, sir. I'm sorry.
Let me not talk about that! Sit down! So, what I want you to do for me is...
Yes, sir.
I want you to take care of...
Take care of
him. Yes. No, that's not what I meant. That's not what I meant.
No, sir.
Shut up. Listen to me. I was thinking more of the lines of you just talking to her on my behalf.
Okay. Yes, I can do that.
That's great. Fucking kill her.
What can I say to her?
Well, you will have to decide upon the exact choice of words. Okay. Essentially, firstly, you need to tell her that it is over between me and her. Right? Over.
Okay.
And you need to tell her also that she needs to vacate her position as my secretary ASAP. And what could be even better is she shouldn't try finding any post in any other department of this building. Or this corporation. Or this country for that matter. This is really important now, okay? And you'll also have to make sure that she takes all this information in the best light possible. She shouldn't try creating problems for me, like claims of sexual harassment, trying to contact my wife every day, and things like that. Essentially what I need is a clean slate.
Sir, that might be a bit difficult.
Okay. If you complete the set task,
yes, sir.
You will have earned my trust. You will have ended this interview on an extremely high note, and taking into consideration key score and smiley face, you will have successfully secured employment in this corporation.
You mean, if I do this, I'll get a job?
Yes.
Sir, what you said that will take care of my
family. Yeah, I'm sure we'll figure something about that, yes.
Okay, yes, I'll do it.
You'll do it?
Yes, sir.
That's great. Okay, then I'll leave it to you.
What? Right now?
Yes, I'm afraid it's a little urgent. I'm just stepping down for a moment. Organize some lunch for the candidate.
Sure.
Thank you.
What should I order?
You're going to order? Doesn't this place like, have a canteen or something?
It does have a canteen, but he prefers people he's interviewing to not leave the room till he's done with them.
Seems harsh.
You could go to the toilets, but that's about it.
I could lose my way, wander into another room.
I would have to escort you to and from the toilet.
Of course you would.
All part of the job.
Well, then why do you do it?
I'm not going in the toilet with you.
I know. I mean your job. It's none of my business, but you seem like the kind of girl who wouldn't be satisfied with just secretary work.
The job has its fun moments.
But I'm sure they're few and far between.
Well, there are days when I get to walk into my boss's office and wire an idiot to the lie detector.
I know it's fake.
You should have seen your face when I connected you to the damn thing.
You really like following these silly rules? Being part of these ludicrous interviews? I bet even he makes it on at this point.
Sometimes, yes, but it's nothing worse than what I would do in any other desk job.
You honestly believe that?
Oh, come on. Tell me one job where you don't have crazy work hours occasionally, where you don't have to deal with abusive clients or customers, where sometimes you don't have to run personal errands for your bosses.
You know, there are names for jobs like that.
Don't talk about things you don't know anything about.
That hurt!
Good!
Well, what you actually like about your job.
There are lots of things.
Right?
The money is good.
You're a secretary. The money can't be that good.
I get some additional bonuses.
Yes, your boyfriend boss.
He likes to pamper me. Yes, buys me lots of gifts.
Maybe he likes to distract you with certain things, so you forget to ask him to leave his wife.
And what's wrong with that? As long as I know what I'm getting myself into.
Nothing, but it's not something you base your entire career on. Haven't you ever dreamt of wanting to do something more?
Of course I did. All of us did.
Like?
I wanted to be a princess in a castle once.
A more realistic dream.
I'm living the most realistic one I've had. Yes, I traded for the crown and castle anyway, but till then I'm quite happy. Thank you.
I think it's a shame.
If it's such a bad place to work in, then why are you here?
I'm applying for management. Yeah, I think it's a little different from what you do.
Middle management, where you do all the work and upper management gets all the credit.
Well, there are some additional incentives being
thrown in. Thought as much. Shit, you're bruising.
It's okay. I'll survive.
He'll see it. I'm not allowed to hit you.
That's a rule.
I don't know what I guess it would be. I'll get some ice.
He wants to end it with you. He wants you to quit your job and never work for him again. I'm serious.
I know you are. He's too afraid to be without me, so he sent you to do what he can't.
No, he wants to end it with you.
He's madly in love with me.
Okay, now you're just being delusional. You said so yourself. He has a wife. You knew what you were getting yourself into.
Wait. You think I'm his plaything? Is that what he told you? Oh, he begged me for months to sleep with him. He writes me these long, painfully boring poems every week. He acts like a little schoolgirl in front of me. And now that the fear of his wife has finally caught up to him, he sent you to do what he can't. That, my friend, is middle management for you. Fine.
Fine what?
He wants to end it. It's no great loss for me.
And you leave?
Fuck no.
You still won't work for him.
You can tell him that if he's too devastated to be around me, he can transfer me to another department. A higher department with better pay.
And if he fires you, you would claim sexual harassment?
And call his wife. Though sexual abuse sounds more dramatic, doesn't it?
Is there no other option we can work out?
If he can pay me my full salary while I sit at home, then I have no issues.
And if that paycheck stopped coming in, you would
call his wife, of course.
What if he gets you a job somewhere else?
No. If he wants to get rid of me, he has to be responsible for me as well. Do you want any other offers I'm going to say no to?
Will you take this to me as soon as you get back?
Sure.
Is there a problem?
No. Sanchez from the canteen, right?
Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah.
It does.
So, how's the interview going?
Okay.
Look, I'm serious. I'm really sorry about earlier. I've been having a very stressful week. You understand, right? I mean, you just got here and I'm assuming that you're conspiring against me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, apology accepted.
So, where has he gone off to now?
He didn't say.
Really? But that's the second time that he's deputy, right? When is he going to be back?
Soon.
Hey, you know what I think? I think he's gone upstairs to tell all the executives about you. What a fine candidate he's found.
No, sir.
And maybe, just maybe, he's marched into the CEO's office and announced that he's found the guy who's going to take a piss on him and steal his job. Although, I must say, you've really got to brush up on your negotiation skills.
You heard everything Sheena just said.
Well, the part where you told her to follow her dreams,
That's quite cute. Eavesdrop often. Very important skill if you want to get ahead in this place. And if you want to get good at it, you've got to practice. Well, I'm sure you're an expert by now. Don't even bother. You're just flattering me. So, you knew about the two of them.
I knew about her the day he hired her. But back then, I admired him. I thought he was quite a guy, you know. Hand-picking his only staff.
But then I found out that he's just a little bitch. And now, so are you. I'm nobody's bitch.
I bet he's promised you everything if you got this done fine. I bet he's conned you into thinking he loves you. And he's slipped in this little task for you. And if you fail, you get nothing.
Am I right? So what? You've just come to watch me crash and burn.
Well, what can I say? I love the show. Can't really blame you though. You've been put in a no-win situation. Come on, man, think about it. It was so simple for him to get rid of her. Wouldn't he have been gone now?
But I thought I'd give her the chance anyway.
You thought that you would give her a chance anyway. For what?
To live.
What? What the hell is that supposed to mean?
You know what it means.
No, I don't. Explain it.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
Just fucking say!
What are you doing in this place, Keith? You think this company has come this far without any casualties? You think this company has become what it is by letting secretaries blackmail the most prized workers?
You're fucking bullshitting me.
This is an unacceptable inconvenience.
I'm just getting rid of it, that's all.
You break into a sweat every time they make you make a transition. No wonder he's going to come out to you. You're not ready for responsibilities.
I can handle any of the workings in this company.
And yet you're terrified of what it does on a daily basis.
We don't do that kind of thing here.
Of course you don't.
You're lying. You're lying. If you wouldn't kill her, you wouldn't have told me.
Nice try.
You're right. I shouldn't have told you.
I just thought you knew what needed to be done, Keith. Nevertheless, I could take care of my mistakes.
Are you threatening me?
What do you think?
You mad? You mad? Are you?
Back so soon. Just as well. I have something very important to discuss with you. Keith! Keith! If you'll excuse us.
What?
He overheard everything.
Shit, I should have known.
He came here to gloat, to tell me I was in a no-win situation.
And what did you say to him?
Sir, seriously?
That I was going to kill you.
You what?
I just told him that I'm not really going to kill you.
That's why he looked.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do now?
Shit, fuck. Well, I really need this job.
Even after all this.
Even after all this.
Just convince him my offer is reasonable.
I saw you running and I remember.
I know, but I need something to get through to him. Something.
He loves me. You can use that.
He doesn't show it.
Trust me. Just convince him not to fire me. Then everything will work out. For all of us. Right? Right?
Right. Hello? Yeah, no, listen, I'm not sure about this place. situation is, but I really don't think this place is a solution. What, you don't think I'm going to take care of my responsibilities? I'll just call you later. Bye.
Is it done?
Not yet.
So, now what?
She's agreed to
it.
But she wants
jobs. Those were not
the
guns
I gave
you, okay?
I know, but she won't cause any trouble as long as you don't fire.
No, I need guns.
She said she'll a promotion in the building.
Really?
Yeah, you could just transfer her to another department. Make sure she's taken care of, and you'll have a breakup.
But no, I gave you such a simple task, I need to do it.
Simple.
You know what? I don't think you are right for this
problem. No, sir.
If you can't achieve something with such an unrealistic goal, then there's no point. That's a ridiculous theory, but I don't know. you become a part of it just because you believe it.
What?
Yes, of course. Take this negative from the with all the loopholes and the bloody corruption, there is a way to deal with people around it. And with things, and with organizations.
Why are you so afraid of it?
What?
If she really means that good to you, it shouldn't be a problem if she continues as a secretary.
Okay. Understand. He is a fucking child. You think even after I've broken up with her, she won't try creating problems for me? Claims of sexual harassment, trying to contact my wife every day, coming here to my office and creating things?
That's bullshit.
I can't handle all this!
That's bullshit and you know it. Sir, even if you didn't want any contact with her, you can just transfer her to another department.
I can't fucking do that! Just transfer her.
You. See, all mighty you. Can't get her pushed up the ladder just a little bit?
That's not the fucking problem.
Then what is?
Fucking you don't understand. I can transfer it to the control or something, but this is not gonna work. Just knowing that she's here in the office, her presence would affect me. And I'm not easily affected. It's her when she's around me. I'm not myself. I do things. I just wanna hold it. I just wanna hold it tightly. You know, this book that's only for me and all this. And when she does that, when she whispers, it infects me and I forget everything. My responsibility is my stature, everything that I strive for my entire life. It suddenly just becomes meaningless. And then I think of my life at that time and realize that all I have is so fucking meaningless. Then why am I holding on to it? Then everything needs to be destroyed. Not changed on my side, fucking destroyed! And when I've destroyed everything, abandoned my family, and set this whole bunch of office on fire, then I will re-act everything. It will be a shock. It is so important. Every single day of miserable fucking night! And after all this living and destruction, only then I will find the contentment and the new identity in the first place, because... Fuck!
Damn it!
Seems like I have some soul searching to do now.
So you're not going to
take over? No, at least not yet.
Well, that's something.
That's something.
So, should we carry on with the interview?
I think we are done with it. But thank you.
Thank you.
Great. Everything that's happened here today, I think you have shown some really impressive resourcefulness under pressure.
Thank you, sir. Does that mean?
No, I still need till the end of the day, you know, to review my notes, keys for it, everything. But I think you have done splendidly.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
No! Okay, what's the meaning of this? Tell anyone about this. You understand? You can't tell anyone about this.
And
why you in particular can't tell anyone about this? Because you remember, when you walked in here, you signed a confidentiality agreement. So, if you breathe a word to anyone outside this room, you have no idea what a legal department will do for you. Then fuck everything that's important to you. Unfortunately, I know what's important to you. You do realize that you have been very open about your private life to me. What? Look at it this way. I gave you a task and you have completed it. I gave you a task and you have used him, you have used your skills, whatever. But you have completed it successfully. So you got the job now. You got the job. So what are you going to do now? Are you going to throw away everything that I've offered you? Or are you going to stay loyal and do your fucking job? Is that a yes? Keep getting it. Where's the board?
In my office.
In your office. Handle it with my post care. With what?
Post care.
And then you will have proved yourself to me. Okay? We just need to remain calm. This will all be over. Okay? We have to keep this among ourselves. Okay? It will all be over. Just remain calm. Okay, Keith. I'm gonna go home now. And I don't want anyone to be calling me unless it's absolutely necessary. Okay? Just remain calm. It'll all be over. Okay? It'll all be over. Just need to remain calm.
What if the authorities find out?
The authorities will be handy. Reduce every day. Come on.
I need a bullet.
Hurry up! My office is down the hall.
Hello? Yeah, I'm fine. I just called to say I got the job. Yeah, I love you too.
Thank you everyone, you have been an amazing audience.